Welcome to Decision 2016. It's a collaboration of the League of Women Voters of St. Lucie County, WPSL Radio, and SLC TV. Now seen everywhere.
Yes, on your smart TV, on your smartphone, and on your tablet, you bet. We're on live on SLC TV and Facebook.com/STLucieGov. And you'll be able to watch us on demand as well on YouTube.com/STLucieGov. And then a little bit later on WPSL.com.
We are here to meet the candidates for St. Lucie County Commission District 5. There are three of them. It's a three-way race, which includes the incumbent, Kim Johnson. Kim is a St. Lucie County native. He was an all-star scholar athlete at Fort Pierce Westwood and Southeast Missouri State University. He's an award-winning teacher in both Missouri and here in St. Lucie County, also a motivational speaker.
Alexander Tommy's family has been here in St. Lucie County long before any of us. As a member of the Seminole tribe, Tommy's family is one of just 300 Indians who managed to elude capture, and that unconquered spirit propels him today. Alex has been involved in Fort Pierce Seminoles, which gives academic and athletic scholarships, and is just the second Seminole to run for public office.
Kathy Townsend has been a business owner here in St. Lucie County for more than two decades. She has a background in real estate, which has been responsible for her success in business. Kathy has spent the last 2 years as chair of St. Lucie County Planning and Zoning Commission and has been involved in several civic organizations over the years. We will rotate where we begin each of the questions, and we'll start with Alexander Tommy. What do you think makes you most qualified to be a St. Lucie County Commissioner?
I think what makes me most qualified, first off, I want to give thanks to the men and women of the League of Women of Organizations in Tomo, Jimmy Stewart, in my native language, which those words have been spoken over this community for many centuries. What makes me the best candidate for this position? I feel that the years of my service with working with Tribal Council and with the Seminole Tribe of Florida has given me the opportunity to be able to work with various different municipalities throughout six different counties throughout the state of Florida. I've also worked with various different United States legislators and some senators along the way about finding ways that we can be able to work together hand in hand with our counterparts within inside of our different county governments. I feel that my experience with understanding exactly how things work within St. Lucie County and also learning how things work in other different counties and watching ways that things are being governed as, I really feel that that if it came time for me to be able to lead in this community. Also, I've just wrapped up with working with the Seminoles, with the Fort Pierce Reservation, also known as Chepco Landing Reservation. I was the reservation manager there in that area for the last 3.5 years. I was in charge of the day-to-day operations of running the reservation. I was in charge of our police department, our healthcare system, and also our recreation systems. Anything that happened on that reservation, it had to go through me for me to understand exactly what it took for me to be able to govern inside of my community. So I feel that if the opportunity was appointed to me, I really feel that I'll be the best person for the job if that time came.
Thank you. And Mr. Johnson, what do you think makes you the most qualified to be St. Lucie County Commissioner?
First of all, I want to thank the League of Women Voters as well as SLC TV and WPSL. With that being said, for me, the reality is I've served this position the last 4 years in service in this position. Even before I got elected, I talked about the airport. I also talked about the port in my campaign. Ironically so, those were two major issues that we dealt with in the fact of right now, we have a Second Street project that the county is working on with the city in order to better position ourselves to create jobs at the port. Those opportunities are coming through, those opportunities are coming through great recruitment at this time of multiple businesses interests as relates to our port. Not only that, I've also talked about the airport, which we are at full capacity right now. We work hard to create a family-friendly atmosphere for businesses to come and create an opportunity for those businesses to succeed and other businesses as a result of it have marketed to their friends and they are now coming to our airport. Third, but not least, And importantly, I have a great relationship with the city mayor of the city of Fort Pierce, as well as the city mayor of the city of Port St. Lucie. One of the things that I also said when I first came on the board is that we need a great deal of camaraderie between North County and South County. We're working in conjunction with both city of Fort Pierce and Port St. Lucie with their boards, as well as our board, to create an atmosphere that's conducive for businesses to come, opportunities to be had, and success to be driven. And lastly as well, we're creating an opportunity for our kids. One of the greatest things that we're doing right now, we have a program that's called Summer of Success, and we're utilizing that to employ an internship for young people that are in high school in our community. So between individuals needing jobs, between families needing their dreams fulfilled, and between young people wanting success, I believe I'm ready to continue to do that job.
Ms. Townsend, what do you think makes you the most qualified to be the St. Lucie County Commissioner?
Well, I also would like to thank the League of Women Voters and you and Greg with PSL Radio, as well as SLC TV, for putting this on. I know what is involved in doing this. My belief is that I have been in this community for 30 years, and I have served here since arriving here with my children. It started off when they were young. I was involved with Little League, and I did multiple things in the traveling team through Little League, and I got to know the kids, and I've been able to watch them grow up, who are now small business owners in the community. I have served on nonprofit boards, and this community is made up of multiple nonprofit foundations and things to raise money, because that is the demographics of St. Lucie County. I've raised close to $1 million serving and chairing those events. I've served as a president of the League of Women Voters for 12 years. So I've worked with government. I've been capable of being able to be in Tallahassee, as well as doing things here locally. I've been a business owner for 30 years. So I think what qualifies me the most is the fact that I've had a business that I owned an assisted living facility. So I know the medical field, and I know the needs of this community medically. I know lodging because I owned the Malampatch Inn Bed and Breakfast for 10 years, and I had diversity there. And I know how government works, and I know what's needed in tourism, and I know how to develop tourism. I've had restaurants, and I have lounges, and I've had multiple companies. I currently am employed in a flat land mowing company. I deal in government contracts. So me being engaged in the community through nonprofits and knowing the needs of the community and being a small business owner has tapped me into the community and knowing the needs that's needed here to bring us forward, to make it better for small businesses to move forward, because I have more experience than both of my opponents sitting up here together. So I have decided to step up and run and hope that in representation of the small businesses, they'll look at my involvement in the community.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Johnson, growth has become a major issue, especially keeping up with the infrastructure of St. Lucie County. What will you do to improve that without burdening the taxpayers over the next 4 years?
Well, one of the things that we really need to look at, we need to look at incentives for businesses as well as developers that want to redevelop current and existing buildings or on current and existing land that are within the urban service boundary. Those men and women who want to develop, let's say you have a dilapidated building and you have a community that's really kind of dormant. We want them to go in there and develop that area or redevelop that area and create a community that's more integrated with the current day technology, current day mentality, current day opportunities. We need to be able to give those men and women who are developers these impact fee benefits by cutting costs down for them if they're going to develop in an area that's dilapidated that needs to be redeveloped. That's number one. Another thing that we could actually do is within that urban service boundary, understand that services don't pay for themselves immediately. It takes it over a period of time. So you definitely want to have development go where services are already provided or near services that are already provided. And if we do both of those things, I think we'll begin to make steps and strides towards growth that's beneficial and possible, not growth that's spread it out, thinned out, and can't get services to.
Ms. Townsend, same question.
Well, I agree with Mr. Johnson, what he said, but I think the other thing for me is We have businesses here that would like to move forward and grow. And when they come to staff and they have a decision to make, if it's a major site plan or minor site plan or something, the restrictions that are put on the churches and the things to develop to make themselves grow to serve the community are things that are not needed. And so they have to go through a long process. They have to put out a lot of money. When at the end, when they go and meet with staff that's involved in it, like engineering or something, they can have fees waived. We need to look at helping serve the businesses that are here as well as businesses wanting to come in and help find ways to reevaluate some of the procedures and ordinances that we have in place so that the burden and the financial burden is not on these companies and the businesses already in existence, so that we can let them move forward and let them grow and let them develop.
Mr. Tommy, same question.
I concur with my colleagues here. I agree that growth could be a bit substantial when it comes to moving into St. Lucie County, into the St. Lucie County area. But the thing is that we need to make sure that we put the focus back on is that we have a mass exit of a lot of businesses that are coming to St. Lucie County. There are a lot of people that want to continue to keep their businesses here in St. Lucie County, but it's a lot of different things that are happening that businesses feel that they're being overly taxed on certain issues when it comes pertaining to those businesses staying here. I feel that if we can continue to be able to work with our business community to be able to find ways and solutions for us to be able to work together with them to be able to bring more businesses here and also continue with the slowdown in our growth process, we can be able to add more people to be able to come here and be able to want to work. Because if you look at St. Lucie County now, we have a lot of people that come into St. Lucie County to work and then they leave out. We need to find ways that we need to keep these people here continuously and want to come and live in this area. But those are just some of my ideas. Now I yield back my time. Thank you.
Thank you. Next question goes to Kathy Townsend. The Indian River Lagoon is not only in trouble, it's officially an emergency at this point. We look to federal, we look to state solutions, but what's the role for the county and the county commission?
Well, I think the role for the county is to work with our representatives that are in Tallahassee. We can't physically go out there and do things that they can do. They can bring the money here. I think right now that our commissioners are doing a good job at working with the funds that are being brought here. But I think that we also need to look at the bigger picture. And the bigger picture is it is the Indian River Lagoon. But as stated in the District 1 and District 3 races, it is bigger than just right here in Indian River on our river. It started up in Orlando and it flows south. And it's multiple things, and it's going to take educating the people. It's going to take reevaluating our septic tanks, which St. Lucie County is doing a great job at that. We are one of the lowest in our tri-county area. But if I'm elected, I will hold the people that are in Tallahassee accountable, that what they say and what they promise that they will do, I will work beside them. And I think that should be the role of us as a commissioner, is to work with the people in the community and go out there and help. But it's also going to start with education and educating the people here on things that we can do with fertilization, septic tanks, and moving forward that way. It's going to be about the accountability.
Mr. Tommy, the role of the county commission, Indian River Lagoon.
I think that the role of the county commission, I feel that with the lagoon, I really feel that some of our policies, I don't think they go far enough. With me being a native of St. Lucie County and understanding these waterways here in St. Lucie County, I feel that for many years, we've always turned our eye to our natural resources that we have in our own backyards. I really feel that we need to make sure that if this commission is going to be able to push to make sure that certain things are happening in Tallahassee, we need to make sure if we go to Tallahassee, put boots on the ground and start pushing our legislators to be able to come into our area for them to understand that we have a serious problem here. If we do not take care of our natural resources, we're not going to be able to live here in this area anymore. I've had an opportunity to go out and look at a few areas over the past week, and it's terrible. And the ways that with the constant dumping that's coming in from Lake Okeechobee, you have to understand that all those waters that's coming in with all those different pestilence that are coming into our area, it's affecting our animals. It's affecting the habitat that we have inside of that lagoon. But I think first it has to start with us first. As members of this community, we have to be good stewards to our environment. If we don't take care of our environment will not take care of us. I yield back my time.
Mr. Johnson.
Well, let me say this, that first of all, there are some things that we are doing, and there are some things that I've met with staff on behind the scenes. First and foremost, we could actually utilize some of the agriculturalists or farmers in the area for water farming. Because think about it, the fruit industry is not here like it used to be. Some of the landowners out west are having the time of their life trying to find a new crop. They're also trying to take care of families that have been a part of their business for years and company for years. So water farming would be a great project. It'll create multiple jobs, and it'll actually deal with the burden that we have with the effects of the lagoon. The second thing that we could actually do, I talked to staff behind the closed doors about this. We have land that we've taken, that we've been given monies to, for St. Lucie County. They call it environmentally sensitive lands. Those lands, we can actually store water naturally on those properties. So if we store water naturally on those properties, if we're also doing water farming, we just left D.C. meeting with Army Corps engineers on C-23, C-24. They have given us, they're going to give us money for design permits, and we've positioned ourselves to have that project speed up a little faster than what we've previously done. And last but not least, I did get a chance to talk to the President of the United States about this issue, and I will be rewriting him a letter and getting in contact with his office and letting him know that we did declare a state of emergency, and now we need you to do so. And if you don't do so, then guess what? It's going to be at the plight of our citizens, our businesses, and our county.
Mr. Tommy, let's talk a little bit about the airport and the port. I mean, those seem to be the two real potential job growth areas. What are your feelings?
Job growth, those areas with the port. I feel that, I think that the port could really work for our area, which I was hearing earlier about, that the port is one of the only areas inside of the state of Florida which is underdeveloped at this time. I know that the city and the county both share a some type of interlocal agreement with those two areas, the two properties that they have in that area. I think that if we can be able to get together and listen exactly what those focus groups that the city has already established over the last year and a half, I think that we should be able to look at ways that we can be able to bring businesses there. With all my background with working with the Seminoles, I've understood exactly what it takes for us to look at different ways of the hospitality industry. But finding ways that we can be able to get people here, not only being able to create shops and to be able to create a different atmosphere here in St. Lucie County, we need to make sure that we always continue to let everybody know that our riverfront, our waterfront that we have here in St. Lucie County is the key to us understanding that once those boats and those yachts and everything come into this area or people travel into this area, we will make sure that that area will be a vibrant area and that that area will be able to create more jobs. Not the short term, but the long term type of jobs. Because for a long time, my county has always been just kicking a can down the road and always giving us short opportunities just to have jobs. We need a full fix on our job system here in St. Lucie County.
Mr. Johnson, same question.
Well, the airport is very important in the port as well. When you take a look at the airport right now, something that we've not done in decades, is at full capacity. That's number one. Number two, we have the number one customs in the nation. So we have a lot of traffic fanfare coming through. And number three, we can have commercial service at our airport, and we will have commercial service at our airport. I myself and the mayor from the city of Fort Pierce just got back. We did a trip to the Bahamas. We did get a chance to speak to the airline there. We also got a chance to speak to members at the port there, trying to develop some relationships within the realm of the scope of doing international business and international opportunities for men and women who live here to take flights over there and vice versa. But we're also in a position too, wherein is we have a business navigator and we also have a new director of director consulting for our ports, which is Stan Payne. And Stan has the ability to reach out to airlines like Delta, airlines like Southwest. And so he's been speaking to some of these airlines and we're looking forward to passenger service at the airport. Along with that, I've sat with multiple men and women who actually take interest in the mega yacht facilities or mega yacht boat building. They've come to St. Lucie County. They've sat down, they've talked with myself, the mayor from the city of Fort Pierce. I myself, Representative Lee, the mayor from the city of Port St. Lucie, and Mayor Hudson of the city of Fort Pierce even went down to Jupiter and visited an area down there and also visited Port Canaveral down in Brevard County. So we've been making an effort to connect those dots, and I believe we will have mega yacht jobs at the airport. We'll have cargo at the, I'm sorry, mega yacht jobs at the port and
Thank
at
you.
The airport as well.
Thank you.
Ms. Townsend.
Well, I support both. I support growth in both of them. I would like to see our port become more of a green port. I would like to see some cargo there. I would like to see it develop into kind of what the downtown Fort Pierce area has done. Downtown's done a great job. They're diversified with businesses from real estate to restaurants. So I think to continue that north down through the port would enhance the Fort Pierce area. With the airport, I am excited about serving as a county commissioner so I can be involved in that. I think that is going to be a huge economic engine to this county. St. Lucie County is blue-collar workers. That's what we have here. We have construction workers. We have forklift operators. We have mechanics. A starting mechanic from an aircraft is $45 an hour. We can offer jobs to people that already live in St. Lucie County and have the experience to be able to find a job out there at our airport by bringing in maintenance. Our airport can do maintenance. Right now, the maintenance on airplanes and in airports is going to Jacksonville, Texas, Atlanta. It's not really being serviced in the southern part of Florida. So if we can approach the people about having the maintenance done at our airports, we could create a lot of jobs for the blue-collar workers we already have sitting right here in our county, increase the rate of pay. They can afford to buy a home. When you buy a home, you take pride in what you own. You take pride in what you have. So when you take pride in that, it automatically cleans up the neighborhood. The neighborhood takes care of itself, and crime goes down. So everybody wins, and I think the airport is the best beginning we have to be able to move us forward in a lot of directions here in St. Lucie County. And I'm excited about seeing it grow.
Okay, next question, we'll go to Kim Johnson. If returned for another term, what's the first major issue you'd like to tackle right away?
Well, there's a lot of things that could be tackled. But I would say this. I look at our kids and their education. And I look at so many young men and young ladies go off to school and never come back home because of particular industries are not here. I believe, based upon, let me say this as well, I know that the port and the airport are areas that we can develop jobs. We talked about an intermodal logistic facility at the airport, which is no more than an inland port at the airport to warehouse major goods for major distribution. That's an opportunity. But for our kids to have jobs, I believe that we need to recruit companies that will work with our education system at the college level to create certifications for our young people to have jobs. I also believe that we need to begin to survey those with disposable income in our communities and find out what they want to do, because that's going to also create jobs. And I believe that if we begin to listen to the young people and hear their dreams and some of the things that they want to do, we can also begin to identify what the future looks like for us. Prime example, Test Kitchen. You got all these high schools today that have these culinary art programs, and they love cooking. So guess what we did? Through our Tercerta, we're doing a test kitchen to create opportunities for them to test their products that they create, as well as develop the possibility of them being able to do fine cuisines, create restaurants, and have their own business success. And I believe in tackling that, we will tackle an opportunity for advancement of our young people and of our county.
Okay, thank you. Ms. Townsend, what is your first major priority you would like to tackle right away?
Well, mine's a little bit different, I think. Mine is restoring hope. I think the residents of St. Lucie County have been misled and they're let down. And I think right now they're just grasping to know that people care. They want to know that people care about their needs. They want to know that people care about their future. And we have a very unique opportunity right now in St. Lucie County that there are really great people running for office. And it's time that people educate themselves and put together in place and elect people that can work together as a team, and that team has the same agenda and that they care about the community and they care about the people. And it's bringing and restoring hope back to our people and back to our community. With doing that, my first thing though would be I'd like to start with repealing the 4% property tax that was just put into place. We are taxed out, our millage rate is high. We have to really look at our taxes. And so my first thing that I would like to do once I'm elected is I would like to reevaluate the recent 4% sales, or not sales tax, I apologize, the recent 4% property tax that was just voted on by the commissioners. Thank you.
Alexander, Tommy, the first thing you'd like to tackle?
That's a great question. First thing that I'd like to tackle, I concur with Mrs. Townsend about repealing that 4% tax line. We are taxed out to the max. And with me being a moderate Democrat, I really feel that we can't continue to keep building our economy here in St. Lucie County on the backs of our young people. Because before it's all over, they're going to be the ones that's going to have to fit that tax bill down the line. The next thing that I would tackle, I will find ways that we can be able to work together with our local law enforcement to be able to bring a understanding to our urban area here in St. Lucie County, finding ways that we can be able to work with people in the community and not just talk to the people in the community, but work together with the people in the community as a whole. The next thing that I would tackle would be parks. I've been traveling around and looking at various different parks in St. Lucie County. There are a lot of parks that are underserved right now. And when you look at the parks, St. Lucie County is supposed to be a beautiful place to go, a beautiful place to bring your family to live. But when you go to these parks and you take your kids to these parks, they are underserved. And I really feel that we need to find ways that we can find ways to put money back into those areas where we've neglected over these last couple of years. The next thing will be the lagoon and the estuary. I really feel that that particular piece, we need to be able to find the hard ways that we can be able to work together with our legislators to get this resolved. And last, I'll reiterate what Mrs. Townsend said. We have to work together as a group. With my background with working with the Seminoles, I've learned a lot about working with people from both sides of the line to get things done for our compact. Thank you.
Thank you. And certainly we are now up to the two-minute closing statement. And let's see, in our rotation, I think we're with Kathy Townsend.
I get to go first. Again, I'd like to thank you and Greg and WPSL Radio, SLC TV, and the League of Women Voters. Great job. Good questions. I know that a lot of people look forward to this candidate forum because this is one of the few opportunities that they have to be able to look at and inform themselves. So, again, thank you, because I know the work that goes into putting this on. I'm a mom, I'm a grandmom, I'm a business owner, and more importantly, I'm one of you. I am somebody that lives in this community every day, and I deal, and I go through everything that you do, and I understand the needs. I've served in this community as a small business owner for 30 years. I've handled government contracts in my businesses. I've had to work with others to reach positive outcomes when things started off negative. But I've been serving on the Planning and Zoning Board for 6 years. I've had the privilege of the last two being the chair of the Planning and Zoning Board. So I've become more familiar with staff, and I know how staff works, and I know more the needs within that need to take place to move us forward. It's invaluable, and it's given me insight. We need to elect people to be our voice and capable of working together as a board to move forward so that we can have a positive change. Hopefully I've gained your trust today and piqued an interest that you'll know more about my views, and you'll want to visit my website at KathyTownsendCampaign.com or visit my Facebook page at Kathy Townsend Campaign. I would like to put the recent 4% property increase back up to the board to repeal it in hopes that we would have a favorable 3-2 vote, or possibly more than 3. And I'd like to build our airports and create better jobs for St. Lucie County. I'd like to support the efforts of moving forward to improving the Indian River Lagoon. So I'm asking you to please vote for Kathy Townsend, and I'd appreciate your vote on August 30th. Thank you.
Thank you. Alexander Tommy, closing statement.
Thank you again to the League of Women Voters. Thank you for the opportunity for me and my opponents to be able to share the stage together to talk about issues that we all can agree on. You ever wonder if St. Lucie County is brave enough to live up to its ideals? Then look to the generations of ordinary citizens that have proven again and again that we are worthy of that. No one should ever be treated unkindly because of the color of their skin or the content of their creed. It is time to listen to a brave, powerful voices of today's new generation of leaders. It is our generation tasked to follow their example on this, to keep building a county where no matter who we are or what we look like or who we love or what we believe, we can be a part of something bigger. But now you have to help me write that next chapter in our county's history. I've had the pleasure of meeting a young woman the other day, and she expressed to me, why should I vote for someone that doesn't understand my problems? Now imagine her, how she told me that particular thing. She has 5 kids. She's working 2 part-time jobs just to make ends meet for her 5 children. That's not right. People are working full-time jobs for part-time pay. In the words of Joe Hollenhorn of Ogla, Lakota Sioux, we have to take care of our environment. Someday the earth will weep and she will beg for her life. She will cry with tears of blood. You will make a choice if you help her or let her die. And when she dies, we will die. We have to realize that we have a problem here in this county, and we need to make sure that we're fixing the problems firsthand and not secondhand. This election is an election of a lifetime for me, because more than any one candidate or policy, what is at stake is a dream that I want to see for this county. That dream is the ability to imagine a better way for ourselves and for our families for tomorrow. That dream. Thank you. And I yield back my time. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Johnson, closing statement.
Well, I would say, first of all, I'm a native of St. Lucie County. And I'm currently the chair of the Board of County Commissioners, which I think at this time, based upon some of the things that our board has done, I think we're positioning ourselves to be a greater county than what we've been in the past. With the Veterans Nursing Facility coming, New Deal with the Mets, our unemployment rate down from about 12.9% to about 5.7%. I believe we're moving in the right direction. We have a great relationship with our legislators. As a matter of fact, Senator Joe Negron will be the president of the Senate this upcoming term, along with a great relationship with Senator Latvala, who will be the appropriations chair. And these are men that we personally know ourselves and have a great relationship with through St. Lucie County and our board. When you look at some of the stuff that I've done, I volunteer my time in the community. I give donations to youth groups. I also give free speeches at middle schools and high schools, and I show up to work every day, not to talk about the job, but to do the job. And I'm here in the office, and whether you have an appointment or not, guess what? My aide will tell you I find a way to see you. And if I need to, I will answer my own phone. Because at the end of the day, people don't want to know how much you know. They want to know how much you care. And I learned this in life. Talking moves three things in life: your teeth, your tongue, your lips, nothing else. And I'm not here to talk about the position. I've done the position, I'm doing the position, and I've been recognized at the state level for my work. I've been recognized at the national level for my work. And as long as you elect me, I will continue to do my work. So please visit reelectkimjohnson.com, and not only visit there, but get out to the poll and vote for kimjohnson.com. Thank you.
Thank you all three for being here, and thank everyone who has taken the time to meet the candidates for St. Lucie County Commission District 5, Alexander Tommy, Kim Johnson, and Kathy Townsend. Thank you very much.
And I want to thank all of the candidates who've made history over 2 days with live television on SLC TV. And you can watch us on demand on youtube.com/stlucygov. And for everyone at SLC TV, thanks for watching Decision 2016.